I was also thinking to myself, here I am again trying to rewrite a narrative that just never even had us in mind from the first place. You know what I mean? Hey, hey, creators. Welcome back to the studio. I'm Aramis, the artist. I feel like it's been a minute, y'all. Has it been a minute? First of all, how you? Okay, how's your spirit? Let me know down in the comments. I'm back in the studio, y'all. Before we even begin, okay, if you are a patron, stop what you're doing right now and head on over to Patreon, because the candles are now live for you and you only, boo, okay? The candles are gonna be going live to the public on Saturday. If I do what I'm supposed to do, y'all are seeing this video on Friday. How I mentioned before, I don't have a lot of candles, and I'm really excited for whoever wants one to have the opportunity to get one, okay? With that being said, let me know how y'all doing. It has been a wonderful, wonderful past few weeks. If you do not follow me on Instagram, first of all, you slipping, because you can get all of these updates in real time. And I've been going close. Going in on the gram, y'all. It's actually been really fun for me to attempt to show up daily. I've actually been attempting to show up twice a day, which has been really good with the candle launch, and also just sharing some of the photography that Jeanette and I have been taking.
Happening right now. Oh my God. Stay tuned. Stay tuned.
Y'all, I'm finally able to share the Climate Pledge Arena painting. Let's hop to that, okay? The family came in town and we had a blast. Let me show y'all inside the new Climate Pledge Arena that's in Seattle.
Okay.
You had to walk up here.
Okay. I'm gonna fall right
now. No, you're not. Don't say it.
Well, I'm in shirt. I work for a lot of
groups. Oh, what? You're in shirt. Some extra
five
days.
Are we jumping?
Woo!
Yeah.
Woo!
Are you gonna follow it? All right, ready?
Oh, that's cool. You gotta send me that.
I feel like we did them all with the family, the ones with me. I'm ready to see the space.
Yeah.
Oh, look at these LED lights. This is crazy. Real deal. Oh. You can see.
Yeah, it was gonna be like the original, like just more logos, and it was gonna be a lot of like financial stuff.
I see.
Honestly, then it was, no, we don't want that. We want something that's gonna speak to our brand, that's gonna speak to like who we are as a company. And 11 months later,
here we are. Yeah. Here we are.
Exactly. I was like, I'm glad you and I said the exact same thing. Here we are.
Literally. That was like so amazing, y'all. My mom flew in town from Chicago. My aunt came as well. Like, my mother is amazing. She's truly my number one supporter. She's always holding me down. So I'm so happy that she was able to come. Y'all, we was all crying. Okay, look, we was crying, and I'm so happy that I could finally share that peace with the world. Y'all know I've been blurring. You know, I've been blurring the background, trying to hide it all. It is officially, it's officially live now. Oh, and let me show y'all too, since they're live, patrons, y'all gonna get these in your mailbox. I'm doing a set that is showing different close-ups of the painting itself. This one is like the full painting, and then this other one is a close-up of the pond, which has elements from Seattle Kraken. I'm gonna leave a link down below if you want to check out the video that we recorded with Zach from Symetra. Actually, I showed y'all the behind the scenes of that a few vlogs ago, so now all that stuff that we had recorded back in July is now live, and now it's October, y'all. It'd be a journey, okay? It'd truly be a journey bringing all these projects to life, but we put a pin in it, we put a button in it, we're all done, and now we're moving on to my next series where majority of the paintings are gonna be self-portraits. So I think in the last vlog I was showing you all this painting process, and let me show you how it looks now. Oh, she's showing her little body, yaddy, yaddy, yay. Somebody come get your girl. Yeah, I was sharing with the Gram fam. I did an IG reel saying how it's just really interesting staring into my own eyes for hours. And it's really just been this beautiful journey of self-love that I'm gonna talk a lot more about, y'all. But I wanna dive into painting. I actually haven't been painting in a while, which is crazy to even think about. But between the house and the candle launch, it's been a lot, okay? But if you're curious, let me show you the candles real quick. They are here, y'all. Ooh, it's the metallic for me. Yeah. What's your sign? Everybody, I need all y'all to drop your sign in the comments below. Let me know if you use a Pisces, an Aquarius, or maybe you like me, use a Gemini, or maybe you a Libra, you right in the middle, you keep the balance, you the anchor. Let me know, boo. But I'm glad to be back. I'm happy y'all here. Let's hop into painting. Thank you. next day, y'all, that's when I started working on this painting. Yeah, I don't think I did any actual painting yesterday. Like, after I had talked with y'all, I had meetings, doing things with the candle launch and all of the goodies. Oh, the create day, right, it was the create day with the patrons yesterday. That was amazing. But yeah, after that, I was like, let me go on home. It was already about 9 o'clock, so it's time for me to head home. But yeah, I'm really excited for the progress that I'm making on this piece. It's been crazy. Actually, it's been really interesting painting myself. I'm literally like, it's weird like constructing my face. But yeah, I think in the last vlog I was talking about doing this idea around like Eve and the snake in the garden. And I'm reading this new reading. Look, Audible, your girl is an Audible, okay. I'm reading this book called The Immortality Key, A Religion That Has No Name. And pretty much like the argument is that like original Western civilizations, Judeo-Christian philosophies were pretty much founded through psychedelics. It's a 14-hour audiobook, okay, and I'm not done. Now, I knew it was gonna have some of that context in it, but I also didn't know to what extent. Like, literally, I feel like the entire book, he's trying to make his case on that. And for me, what I was interested to learn more about was this actual, like, religion that had no name. Just to talk more about their, like, beliefs, philosophies, principles. And I feel like in the beginning it did, but now it's kind of going in a different direction. But it also like really inspired me to actually not do the idea that I was doing, because I just feel like we have this almost obsession with like Greek and Roman culture and how much our like Western civilization really admires ancient civilizations to the point where we like just revere them when it comes down to different like megaliths that's been built in different spaces. But you don't really have any acknowledgement of African culture, but specifically West African culture. I feel like we love the Egyptians, right? Like, I love the look, okay, your girl got a scarab tattoo right here, okay? The love for Egyptian culture is real, but I also feel like when it comes down for me, the brown-skinned black girl out here, I know my people come from more of West Africa. And so I've like went on this rabbit hole on the internet. I'm the person on YouTube who watches like all the weird documentaries, okay, about like ancient civilizations, aliens, documentaries about like megaliths, Göbekli Tepe, like the whole thing, right? I'm here for it. And I was like, let me Google if there's any megaliths in West Africa. And the reason why I was specifically looking for megaliths is because I feel like whenever we find a megalith, especially connected to ancient civilization, we're all in awe because we have no idea how these structures were built, right? Like, it's these giant ass rocks and these stones that's like more than five tons. And we're like, how did they move this? Like, we haven't found really no tools. Like, okay, we didn't found a hat, an axe, and a knife and some jewelry, but has anybody found a pulley, a crane? Like, nothing, you know? And so I think I associate whenever we find any sort of like megalithic structures, you have some sort of like advanced ancient civilization. What does advanced mean? Who knows, right? But for me, I'm like, okay, I haven't really seen anything like that. I haven't even heard anything about that when it comes down to West Africa. And so I did some Google searching and I found these megaliths that they really don't even know how these rocks got there. They kind of look like Stonehenge. It's these circles made of stone. It's actually in Senegal. It's actually in like the Senegambia region. I definitely plan on going to Senegal, and that's something that I wanna have a better understanding about. I'm a person who is deep into like metaphysics, the esoteric philosophies of the power of spoken word, how our thoughts manifest into reality. And so I was like, all the mythology that we have, like all the philosophies from the Greeks and the Romans and the Sumerians and the Aztecs, like somebody wrote those stories. Like, when you think about our creation stories, somebody wrote those. Like, nobody genuinely can say, like, I know for 100% fact how we got here. Nobody knows. And every single culture has a different origin story or a different creation myth. And so, in the midst of me toying with these ideas of rewriting the narrative of Eve in the garden and trying to remove this demonization of the snake, I was also thinking to myself, here we are again, or here I am again, trying to rewrite a narrative that just never even had us in mind from the first place. You know what I mean? And I feel like I always think about conversations, especially about like race and diversity and Black women and women in general. It's like a lot of our ideas or a lot of the things that can be spoken about is one, trying to prove worthiness to somebody, like trying to insert ourselves into somebody else's narrative or trying to expose some level of oppression that a lot of people was like, oh, really? Is this what you all's been going through? And I'm not here to, I feel like I'm expanding into this space of like not trying to prove anything anymore to anybody and not trying to put myself in a story or in a philosophy that doesn't even resonate with me. And so the same way that people from the past created their own stories and created their own creation myths about how we came into form and how we came into being, it's like, why can't I create a creation story, or at least a creation story for me? And so this painting that I'm working on is really like my concept of how thoughts manifest into things and how it's like this cyclical process of just, I mean, and of course this makes perfect sense for the person who is deep into the like law of attraction space, but even deeper than that, like I listen to like Florence Shovelshin on repeat every morning. If you don't know who she is, I'm gonna drop a link below. Like, you gotta listen to her audiobook, the Game of Life and How to Play It. Absolutely love that book. And I was raised in a Christian household, and I don't identify myself as Christian anymore, but like Jesus is my homeboy though. Like bruh was dropping knowledge and was dropping truth. And it's unfortunate how like Judeo-Christian philosophy has caused a lot of harm throughout so many different people in the name of God. And it's like, wow. I feel like when you really tap into what spirit and source is truly trying to say, I believe that it's saying that it's all within us, you know? In the same way that all these things came into form, we have the same power to bring something into form and to be able to manifest something into this reality. And so that's really where this piece came from. You all might've saw from the last vlog, I was thinking about putting the apple in the hand, or maybe not, like maybe just having some energy. I had mentioned that she's giving me different vibes. Like, she's not giving me Eve vibes. Clearly it's me, right? Like, has this been focused on the painting the whole time? Wow, okay. I was trying to call it myself, blocking her out and looking in the lens, but of course it wants to focus on the big ass face behind me. So yeah, the color palette that I'm using is also showing how it's all connected, like the same way this body and vessel is a certain color palette and the hair is a certain color palette. It's the same energy that's now being transmuted into the cosmos, but it's coming back and being created into form. In that form, I'm thinking about maybe doing some roses down here or doing something that represents something connected to the planet, but also bringing something that blooms, you know, something that slowly takes time and slowly evolves. Yeah, so that's where we're taking the painting. I didn't even record much, y'all. I was literally just listening to my other audiobooks and vibing out to that. Overall, I have no idea what I'm doing with this painting or like where it's going, but oh, I actually do know where it's going in this physical space, in this physical realm. This piece is gonna be up on display at the Vivid Matter Collective Gallery that's in Capitol Hill. So remember, we had a pop-up there. I was selling the V-pins and all those things. We converted the space to a gallery, and every 2 months, we're gonna be rotating out artists who's a part of the collective. So Barry Johnson, he was the first artist, now it's my turn. I'm gonna be having this piece on display up from November and December. Y'all should hop on a newsletter, okay? Look, all of it's gonna be in a newsletter. Join the newsletter. And that's where I'm gonna be sharing information about the candles. But if you're watching this right now, I think the candles are public. I think the candles are officially public right now, which like makes me super excited and makes me a little nervous for you, boo. Okay, I'm feeling like them candles gonna go really fast, and I'm super excited about it. Okay, we're gonna wrap it up there. Remember, if you like this video, like it, and I'll see you all next week. Editing Aramis. Okay, hi, Editing Aramis. So now you wanna insert. Look, I'm scripted by my own self.